I love Big Lake. I like my coworkers, the community.
Great families, great people, great teaching staff, and I think we've just done a lot for our community and they do a lot for us.
Our community needs the schools. It helps our kids grow. It helps them learn the skills they need to become the adults that we need them to be.
For some students, schools is their home away from home. So we've got to invest in not only our people, but also in our facilities.
You can tell that we've taken a lot of pride in our facilities. We've done a lot of work in recent years, but we have a fantastic opportunity here to really maintain and maximize what we've got going, existing in place, not just for the students right now, but into the future as well.
We're just asking our community to invest to help maintain our current facilities and restore and renew some of our spaces so that we can continue to maintain that wow factor when visitors come into our buildings. On November 2nd, Big Lake Schools will be asking our community to vote on a one-question ballot for a $30 million bond referendum that will restore and renew our current spaces across the district. This is the opportune time for this to occur, as our district has debt that is expiring and the referendum would have no tax increase to our community.
It is really important for us to be good stewards of our taxpayer dollars. We formed a building advisory committee last spring. That committee consisted of school board members, community members, principals, and other district administrative leaders. And so we had a series of meetings last spring. In addition to those meetings, the district also conducted a survey of our community and gathered some feedback from them to determine what our priorities should be.
We do have some pressing needs coming in the near future, such as finishing replacing roofs that have reached the end of their life cycle, redesigning our career and technical educational spaces, and our media centers to make them more ideal for 21st century learning. We'd also provide a great opportunity to do some remodeling in our special education spaces to provide a more equitable educational experience. We've got some HVAC needs at our Independence Elementary School, as well as our high school, and then some controls updates that need to take place at all of our facilities in order to maintain proper building temperature and humidity throughout all seasons. The passing of this referendum, we'd also look to relocate the high school weight room and to provide a space that will allow physical education on lifelong fitness while also providing adequate space for athletics, programming, and strength and conditioning. We'd also take the time to do some reconfiguration of our parking lot at Liberty Elementary School. Another need that has been brought up in the past is our scoreboards. We've got scoreboards that are no longer serviceable and we can no longer receive parts for.
The building referendum is much like you would reinvest in your home. For example, if your roof is leaking, you need to fix it. If your furnace is broke or is aging, you need to replace that. If you find the spaces in your home don't meet your needs, you may look at a different way of how you want to utilize those spaces and remodel it. So it's those types of needs that we have included in our building bond referendum plan.
When we invest in our buildings, I mean, who comes to the buildings but students? And why are we here? These aren't just buildings to just be buildings. These are buildings to educate kids. And our purpose is to get these buildings to be the best place for the kids to learn.
What I'm really excited for is not just an education and a future for my kids, but the chance to get the best education, the best future.
What this is about is taking the programs and the spaces that we currently have and maximizing them, enhancing them, and renewing them so that we can provide the best possible education experience for our students here at Big Lake Schools. Please make it a priority to learn more about this upcoming referendum, and don't forget to vote on or before November 2nd.